Welcome back from the break. We're glad you're still watching. Now remember, the show airs every Thursdays at 10 p.m. and the repeat is on Saturdays at 8 a.m. So feel free to make a date and watch this program because it helps you, the business person, but also you that is thinking of starting up something. Here is the only place where you can find those tips that you need to pay attention to for you before you start that business. Now, molasses is a vicious substance resulting from refining sugarcane or cane bits into sugar. Now, molasses varies in the amount of sugar, the method of extraction, and age of the plant. But did you know that sugarcane molasses is primarily used to sweeten and flavor foods? Maybe you know now, right? Well, tonight we run you through how this is done and how actually you could be making the money. We were in Jinja and let's take you through how to make money. We'll see you shortly.
Walumbe Jagare Mill. Some people call it a sugar factory because it crushes sugar cane. Others call it a sugar mill because it mills the sugar cane. But I call it a Jagare Mill. Jagare translated, the very many people don't understand Jagare. Jagare, what Jagare means, but Jagare means this. What other people call akalo do in Uganda or sukari guru in Lusoga. So I am happy to note that I am having something doing about the sugar cane in the sugar industry, which has been in crumbles for some time, in about 3 or 4 years the sugar industry had crumbled a bit. But my coming around in this area has improved the sugar industry more to the side of harvesting the cane, which is ready, giving a price to the sugar cane, which was expected to drop, and trying to add value to the jaggery, which also had dropped in the local market, but now it has gone up. Yeah, this is who I am, Mr. Investor. Yeah, during the Best Farmers competition, I successfully was selected as one of the best farmers and was allocated some finances, which I have to tell you that I utilized right here for the start of my industry. And when we went to the Netherlands, I cannot say I found sugarcane in the Netherlands. But what I found in the Netherlands helped me to adjust on my native crop at home. They have crops that they grow, or plants that they grow in the Netherlands. But they progress with their plantations. Now the plantation that I have with my family is sugarcane. So I sought for all means of adding value and progressing with the sugarcane. This is why I came back and started the Jagare Mill, which is crushing and adding value to and trying to do this jaggery that we are making. What I learned from that side is the fact that they never give up on anything. They never give up. Someone says, I have one cow, or I had one cow, then we fed it, it produced the other. Now I'm trying to focus on cane, on sugar cane. Put a focus on it. What can come out of sugar cane? Can I add value on cane? Can I get jaggery? Can I get actual sugar Can I get molasses? Can I get paper from bagasse? Can I make cardboards from bagasse? Can I stop the deforestation around by using bagasse as energy? These are the things that move in my mind. They move in my mind. They are like a sickness within me. And that is what makes me do what I am doing now. The Netherlands, I learned from somebody who... We went somewhere close to Germany. I don't remember the province, but we went somewhere close to Germany, where I met some guy who said, in Germany, they still make some jaggery, but it is almost like trying to fence. But the type of boilers that they use are in this shape. This guy gave me a format of how to make the boilers. These boilers are run by a fan that blows air into the furnace to make the fire. And this is an easy way to burn the bagasse. There's a fan that blows the air inside all the time. And this is the best. I just love the system. I love it. Currently, we are using about 60 people. But of course, numbers can even escalate from that. Because very many people, by the way, are not employed. They are not employed. And our presence here has helped this community a lot. Right from Buyengo, Muguluka. Let me call Buyengo, Kambocha, Muguluka, Butagaya, Budondo, Buwenge, Bulopa, Bupadengo. So many people gather to my place here in pursuit for employment. What are they looking for? They are looking for a vehicle to go and load the cane. They are looking for where they can sell their cane. They are looking for how to feed the machine. They are looking for taking this to the market to go and sell. So the numbers may escalate in a few years. I may have bigger more numbers. But 60 is the people that I have here, then over 100 in the fields working. And you know what is helping me to still have a success with these people is the confidence that I show them and the confidence they show me. In times when you are not straightforward, no worker will trust you. No one. But I am a very straightforward person. Straightforward, straight to the point. You're not working, I tell you you're not working. That is it. You're working, I appreciate your work. We keep appreciating and they trust on us. They trust. Because we have built trust, that's why we still have workers. And that's why we are still existing. And that's why we are progressing. Cane is a gold. Sugar cane is a gold. And you know, everybody has gold, but how you handle your gold matters. To us, sugar cane is gold. Now we cannot go for silver. We will not. We will not go for madam. No. We will not go for matoke. There's no gold in our matoke. There's no gold. Matoke is food, just food. But this is a cash crop. This is a cash crop. We need cash. So we call it gold. We are like, which one should we choose? Sugarcane has a lot, what they may call ingredients. But I'm talking about a lot of benefits. You produce sugar, edible sugar that you're using in tea. You produce molasses that we use on animals. And some other people also use it for ethanol making. You produce bagasse that we use for energy. you produce plasmid that we use as fertilizer. You produce cardboards that comes out of bagasse. You make paper from bagasse. You make charcoal from bagasse. A lot. What I'm mentioning is just a few of the things that come out of sugarcane. To the extent that I want to put up an ethanol plant right here in this area, such that every sugarcane that I come, I bring and make this type. This is just for storage. I can store this, and then afterwards, I just put in my plant to make the ethanol. Or I make direct juice to go and make ethanol. But when I have excess, I make this and store, then I make the ethanol later, because this can stay over 12 months. Now, people like this, it is a product. Diabetic people can also use it. It is not harmful to them. And I assure you, nobody's gonna refuse you from taking this. They like it. People buy it. I have the market, ready market. I take to supermarkets and I find everything has been taken. Everything has been taken. So they order for more, Everything that comes out that I make, people just take. Like, bring more. It is working. Number one, employment. I'm dealing with people. Number two, value addition. I'm adding value to sugarcane. Number three, consistency. I am progressing. What is number four? It is me. I am working. However small, but I am working.
So there you have it. The gentleman was once featured on Harvest Money, which is an initiative of the Vision Group here that seeks to reward farmers creating a difference. Of course, those that are thriving out there and making agriculture something that could, you know, have more people moving into thanks to how much they get. And of course, I hope you've learned something. It's popularly called Sukari Guru. Yes, I know that is what most of you would say, but it is something that you can look into. There are several opportunities that you can embrace on how to make money. The most important thing is, do you pay attention to the basics that you must? Do you treat your business with respect? Are you offering a service that is needed to society, or are you simply making profits? But also, market research should be important for you that is planning to start out something, mostly on how to make money. So I hope you've learned a thing or two. Let's talk personal finance tips for this week. And we have had a lot of people and horror stories around debt, such as, well, the bank took my property, the money lender did this and that, and so many other things, okay? And yet many of us have acquired debt in forms from bank loans to money lenders and to siblings. Debt is good. But how can you manage a debt? Whether debt is good or bad is dependent on how you view it. Why are you taking that money? And how can you make sure that the money you're borrowing does the exact reason you're taking it up for as a loan? Personal finance for this week.
Hello viewers, thank you for watching The Business Show. My name is Caroline Mary Amase, a certified financial literacy trainer and a social entrepreneur.
Well, see, everyone talks about debt as something that is bad. What is your take as a financial expert?
First of all, we need to understand what a debt is. A debt is basically money owed by one party to another person. The aspect of it being bad or good entirely depends on the borrower. This brings us to what a bad or good debt is. It is you, the borrower, who makes the debt bad or good. Usually when we borrow money for a specific purpose, when we tailor that money to that specific goal for which we borrowed, we are able to use it carefully and wisely towards that specific goal. But whenever we borrow money for one goal and divert it to something else, it ends up becoming a bad loan or bad debt, because we have diverted the intention to something else that is not going to actually give you returns that will enable you pay back debt.
So in such uncertain times, when the cost of living is, you know, skyrocketing every day, many people are looking out for money, and the money lenders are out there, the banks are out there. I know that people would want to take, you know, debt to survive. What are some of the things they need to look out for if they're going to take a debt, and must they take a debt anyway?
Now, borrowing money comes in very handy, especially when you're looking towards attaining a specific lump sum of money for purposes of recapitalization, investment, or emergencies, and many others. However, using your own money puts you at a free situation that you're not by any reason under pressure while using that money. There are so many things that come with borrowing money, including obligations that a borrower must meet and also interest that a borrower must pay back depending on the source of that debt. So while we borrow money, it is important that first of all, we purpose to spend that money on the things that we borrowed for, and also putting into consideration that it's not our money. The way we handle it should be with extreme care. There's so much pressure with borrowed money, given, for example, the language, the phrases, and all the costs that would come with debt in case of any default. So borrowing money is not something that is bad. It is something that we will always do as long as we reach that point of emergency, as long as we reach that point of when we want to grow our businesses. It is something that we cannot run from, but we just ought to be careful and to adopt certain things if we are to become better debt managers. It is something that we cannot run away from, but we just have to adopt, embrace it while managing it well.
How can one manage their debt and live a fulfilled life?
To manage debt, first of all, the very first step while managing debt is to understand how much you owe people. And this comes with making a list of all your debts. Once you know the amount of money that you owe people, you are in a better position to strategize better. You understand how much, for example, you owe. You understand what's the amount that I require to be paying in installments, and what is the interest, and on which day, for example, of the month, am I supposed to pay back that money? After that step one of making a list and identifying your debt value, you then move forward to having a payment plan. Having a payment plan will advise you on, for example, how much money you need to put aside monthly for debt payments. We'll also advise you whether you need to start with clearing large debts or small debts. You can also strategize and plan better whether to consolidate your debts into one lump sum and then look forward into paying slowly. Now, all these things we are saying, consolidating debts, understanding which amount you need to pay, for example, monthly, it still goes back to the fact that it is personal, given that we all earn money differently. For example, I might earn daily, someone else might earn weekly, someone else might earn monthly. So as we do all the planning and all the strategizing, we need to acknowledge that it is something done personally.
So part three of our personal finance tips with Caroline there, and I hope you've learned something. I'm not saying it's bad to take a date. Mm-mm. What is important is when you take the date, what are you using the money for? It's important that the money you're borrowing goes to the right channels that you had aligned. Don't take a date if you do not have a budget, because then you'll end up using the money anyhow. So before you take a date, before you go to a bank or a money lender, sit down, draft a budget, and then move out there so that when you get the money, you're sure of how you want to spend that money. Well, the week opened with the shilling trading at about 3,805 and 3,815 levels, and closed at 3,810 and 3,820 levels. Of course, the corporate companies' taxes did come through, and it kind of just helped the dollar to cool down, and the shilling kind of just stabilized. Let's now look at a comprehensive report on the money markets report. So, like I said at the start of the show, the shocks on electricity and fuel in Kenya after the subsidies were put off, we're just hoping that it doesn't spill into Uganda, because like last week we had a prices already dropping of the pump stations to about 6550, and like I said, the tip for last week was, if you consider fuel cheaper at a particular station, the question should be, at what cost will it make or put on that engine? So if you take fuel at 5,800, that is cheaper, but in the long run you might pay a huger cost compared to a guy taking fuel at 6,550. Let's now take a look at how the major cities are faring in regards to fuel prices. So there you have it, across the major cities. And if you're a business person and every day you're stepping out to try out something, I keep saying, and I'll say it again, don't just do the ordinary. Try and be different from others. Do something that sets a bar you off. And the people that come around your business will tell you, you know what, we are here because of ABCD. Maybe one, you have good customer care. Two, you make follow-up calls to find out whether the clients loved your products. Three, you accept back the products in case they don't work for the people. But also four, you're generally a good person to work with. It's important that you allow all this in your business, because then you'll be able to attract clients. But also it's important for you to allow some people just come in and do window shopping. I've seen instances where you walk into a shop, do window shopping, and someone simply tells you, wait, so you're not buying nothing. No, I'm not buying anything. I'm simply seeing for now, go back, plan, and come back and shop. So as a business person, you must learn to allow all this in your business. Of course, sugar prices and rice skyrocketing. Plan how you spend. It is important that you buy things in bulk than buying a kilo or two or three. You'll find that if you bought 10 kilos in a go, you could save some money, and that could take you longer. That should do for this week's edition. Thank you so much for joining us. Feel free to get back in touch and tell us what you think about the show, plus the topics that you think we need to address. And of course, for those of you that watch Business Clinic, while it's on Tuesdays at 7:30 to 8 with me, Simon, still on the Rush Hour, where we dissect the different issues in your business. So make a date with us. Until then, you take care. I'll see you soon. Bye for now.